Hey there, Benjamin from LoveStarter here, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Google Search Console to begin optimizing your website. We'll look at how you can add your website. I'll run through some of the most important reports in Search Console and how you can identify insights that will help you improve your existing content and write new content to attract new visitors and prospects to your website. Okay, so Google Search Console lets you access a range of reports about how your website performs in the organic search results on Google. In order to access these reports, you will need to verify that you are the owner of the website. This is to protect your data so that other people, like your competitors, can't just access the reports too. So let's start by taking a look at how you can verify your website. I've already logged into Google Search Console and we can see I've already verified my personal site. Let's click this on the top left corner. And let's choose Add Property. When you add your website to Google Search Console, you can choose to add it as a domain property or a URL prefix property. In most cases, I recommend adding and verifying your website as a domain property. This will mean you add your top-level domain to Google Search Console, and then any subdomains will automatically be included in your reports. The URL prefix option lets you verify a specific URL. So if you verify HTTPS, www. And then your domain, only that domain will be available in Google Search Console. You won't be able to report on any other subdomains or if people can access your website without the www. So I'm going to enter my top-level domain using the domain option. And then I'm going to click Continue. To verify that we own the domain, we need access to the domain through our domain name provider. We need to add a DNS record to our domain. If you don't have access to create new records, then I recommend finding out who does have access for your domain. Otherwise, if you can't get access, you'll need to verify your domain using the URL prefix option we saw in the previous step. Okay, we can see this tells us we need to add a TXT record, so let's copy this. For my website, I'm using Cloudflare to look after the DNS records, so let's head to Cloudflare. I've already logged into Cloudflare and selected DNS. So all we need to do is click Add Record, select TXT as the type, enter @, paste the value we copied from Google Search Console, and click Save. If you're not using Cloudflare, then the steps to add the record will probably be a little different, so I recommend searching the support articles for your domain name provider. Okay, we've now added the record to our domain, so let's head back to Google Search Console. Now let's click Verify. We've now successfully verified our website in Google Search Console. Let's go to the property. We can see we will need to wait before we will see data in the reports, so let's navigate to the property I already verified. The menu on the left lets you travel between the different reports for your property. The performance report lets you view the search queries people have entered to find your website, along with the pages that have been shown in the search results. We will come back to this report in a moment. The URL inspection option lets you enter the URL for a page on your website to see if the page is being indexed by Google or not. Let's enter a URL to take a look. We can see the page has been indexed, and we can also access additional details about the page. And let's enter another URL. We can see this page isn't indexed by Google. So we can use the Test Live URL button to check that the page is available. And if it is, you can request to have the page indexed. The coverage report shows you details for all of the pages on your website. This includes any errors that Google has identified. Pages with warnings, pages that have been indexed without any issues, and pages that have been excluded. You can select these options at the top to update the visualization, and more importantly, view individual details below the graph. You can then select one of the rows to view granular details. The Sitemaps option lets you view sitemaps Google has found. For my personal site, I don't have a sitemap, but you will see your sitemaps listed here, along with the number of URLs contained in the sitemap and any potential issues. And you also have the option of submitting a sitemap at the top. The Removals option lets you enter URLs you would like to be removed from Google's index. The Page Experience report tells you if Google thinks you are providing a good experience to users on your website. This looks at things like loading speed, mobile usability, and security for the pages on your website. Core Web Vitals provides more details about any issues relating to the loading speed of your website. It basically looks at how quickly your pages and content load for people. Pages will be listed as poor, needs improvement, or good. And Mobile Usability tells you if Google has identified any issues relating to how people experience your website on mobile devices. Apart from these reports, you might also see additional reports in Google Search Console. For example, if you have AMP or accelerated mobile pages, then you'll see details for those pages on your website too. Now that we've covered what the different reports provide in Google Search Console, let's look at how we can use the performance report to begin optimizing our content. I need to flag that my personal site is a one-page site that I really haven't optimized. So I recommend opening your own Google Search Console reports and following along with your own data. Okay, let's select performance. We can see the report is showing us the number of clicks and impressions for our website. Let's also select Average Click-Through Rate and Average Position at the top. This will add these additional metrics to the report. You'll see the search queries people have used to find your website listed below the graph, and the search queries with the most clicks will be listed first. You can now spend time identifying search queries that are relevant to your business that have a lower than expected click-through rate, CTR. I recommend starting with ones that have a CTR that is less than 6%. You can add a filter to help pinpoint these pages quickly. To do this, click the filter icon on the top right corner of the table. Then select CTR and change equals to smaller than and enter 6. This will give you a list of search queries that you can then use to optimize your content. Also, keep an eye out for search queries that have a strong CTR but aren't showing an average position in the top 10 organic results. There might be opportunities to optimize for these search queries too. Now I want you to click on a search query that you want to optimize, and then select the Pages tab. This will show you the page or pages that you can optimize on your website. I recommend creating a list of around 5 pages you want to optimize. This will give you a good starting point, and you can then repeat this process to identify additional pages that you can improve on your website. You can also look at your landing pages. To do this, let's remove the search query at the top. And let's check that the Pages tab is selected below the graph. Now we can look for pages that have a lower click-through rate. I recommend looking for pages that have a click-through rate below 4%. Again, you can add a filter to narrow the results in your report. I also recommend making a note of any pages that have a higher than expected CTR. Analyzing these pages might help you pinpoint content that is already working well for your audience, so you can apply similar strategies to your other content. Once you have a list of around 5 pages that you feel could be improved, you should open those pages on your website and come up with ideas to improve the content. This could include improving the page titles, descriptions, and of course, improving the content on the page, images, graphics, and more. For example, you might have identified a page that isn't performing well, and you discover it doesn't have much content, so you could then spend time expanding the content that is included on the page. You might even add an additional image or other material to provide more valuable information to your audience. You're now identifying opportunities to improve your content and website using insights from Google Search Console. Once you've made a change, you can then check back in a month or so to see if you've improved your results. A great way to do this is to select the date range at the top of the report and click the Compare tab. This will let you compare two date ranges. Are you using Search Console to improve your content? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.